For many people, backing up a trailer can be challenging, especially if you're in a new place or there's people watching.
Then you want to look like a pro. So we made a trailer parking sensor. Stay tuned and we'll show you how we did it. So, what do we need to build this, Mike?
Well, we need to build a sensor that can actually measure how far we can back up the trailer. So I think we should use the Arduino Nano as the brains.
Nano is a good choice, but won't the 80 Tiny be a better choice in terms of battery life?
Well, yeah, but the device is not going to be turned on for any long periods of time. So I think the convenience of the Arduino Nano, that it's easier to program and also easier to get a hold of, makes it a better choice. But what are your thoughts on getting the signal from the sensor and into the car?
First, I was thinking about using an FM sender and use the car stereo as the receiver part.
Ooh, smart. But is that actually legal?
That might be a problem, Mike. Different countries have different rules regarding how to use the FM band. So I did some experiments with the NRF24L01 and found it would be a good choice in this build.
Okay, so you're thinking building a sender, a sensor and a receiver in the car.
Yeah, that's right, Mike.
Mike and Chris are going to build two boxes. The first will be attached to the trailer and send signals wirelessly using the NRF24L01 transceiver to the second box that is inside the car. The transceiver operates on 2.4 GHz. That's the same band as Wi-Fi, so that should be okay to use in most parts of the world, but remember to always check your local regulations before you broadcast anything.
Okay, so we're going to use the Arduino Nano as the brains in both the sender and the receiver. We're going to use the NRF for transferring the data. So all we need now is a waterproof ultrasonic distance sensor that can measure distance and how far we can actually back up.
Yeah, I think the JSN SR04T would be good for this project. It's waterproof and it also has a wide angle of detection. So if you start on the code, Mike, I'll handle the waterproof casing and also how to power it up.
Great, sounds like a plan.
Okay.
An ultrasonic sensor works by sending out inaudible sound waves. By measuring the time it takes for the sound waves to bounce back from an object, we can measure the distance. When the sensor measures a distance less than 2 meters, the receiver in the car starts beeping using a buzzer. As the distance becomes shorter, the beeps will become more and more frequent. Once the trailer is only 30 centimeters from an object, the buzzer will give off a continuous tone.
As Mike started on the code, I started by figuring out the enclosure. I quickly settled on a decent size electronic box, where I prepared the surface and glued on 4 strong magnets with epoxy glue. Then I use a Dremel tool to make hole for the ultrasonic sensor that needs to stick out of the box. This box has some flexible rubber pads on the sides for inserting wires. I used one of them to mount an on-off switch that is simply attached to one of the battery holders.
While Chris stepped out, I stepped in and did the wiring. We prefer to use the old school technique of wire wrapping. This will give a more reliable connection than jumper wires, and it's both faster and cheaper than crimping wires. As a bonus, the completed build will also take up less space and look better when you twist the wires. The wire diagram can be found in the description.
This is the completed box. I have attached the components with hot glue and double-sided tape to hold them in place. It's important that you keep the NRF transceiver as far away from the batteries as possible, as mounting on too close will limit your range.
And this is the box that goes inside the car. is wired pretty much the same way as the sender. We got the Arduino Nano connected to the NRF24LO1. And instead of using the ultrasonic sensor, we connected it to a buzzer. Apart from that, we're not using batteries, but we're rather using USB into the 5-volt pin of the Arduino. The coding part went fairly smooth. We bought the second version of the JSN SR04T, so we had to adjust the timing of the trigger pin. But this is now fixed in the code, so it will automatically work with both versions. Adjust the min and alert distance if you need to. This is documented in the code. Then just upload the sender code to the sender, aka the sensor, and the receiver code to the receiver. Link to the codes can be found in the description.
And now it is time to see if the devices actually work. So Chris and Mike are ready for a field test.
When you arrive at the location you want to back up your trailer, just turn on the device and pop it on.
Inside the car, plug in the receiver to the USB outlets.
Okay, Chris, it worked like a charm.
Yeah, it did.
If you're going to rebuild it, is there anything you would do differently?
Yeah, Mike. I would skip the two AA battery holders and rather go for a 9-volt battery. It's smaller and it's more convenient.
Sounds good. So if you want to see the next video, remember to subscribe.
And like.
See you next time.